This story is told in a female perspective. It happened to me when I was around 15 years old. I would always love going to this arcade that was located close to my house. The arcade was always open till late, so it was usually packed to full capacity. My parents didn't mind if I went by myself, as long as I made it back before my curfew was over. Every time I was at this arcade, I would always play with the Pac-Man machine. I don't know why, it's just I had a knack for Pac-Man and it was my favorite game to play. Later that night, I remember seeing these two guys play the game Dance Dance Revolution. I always enjoyed watching others play it, as it was quite mesmerizing to say the least. That's when a random guy approached me from out of the blue and asked if I'd be interested in playing air hockey with him. I personally didn't see any harm in it, so I said, sure. He introduces himself as Ben, and I introduce myself as well. We end up playing a few rounds and even chatted for a bit. Ben was even generous enough to buy me a drink. I eventually noticed it was getting pretty late and realized it was probably close to my curfew. I checked my pockets and noticed my phone was missing. I didn't know if I forgot it at home or something, so I tell Ben that it was time for me to go. He then tells me that he needs to use the restroom and politely asks if I could keep an eye on his cell phone, which was charging on the wall along with his belongings. I said sure, and he proceeds to head to the restroom. I decided to call my cell phone using Ben's phone, just in case I accidentally dropped it somewhere in the arcade. I noticed he didn't have a pass lock on it, so it was pretty easy to use. I dial my number and surprisingly hear a cell phone ringing inside Ben's backpack. It sounded exactly like my ringtone. My phone must have been in his bag. I decide to open the bag, only to find my phone inside it. I grab my phone and quickly place the backpack back on the table, just in case Ben came back. I felt really uncomfortable knowing he had attempted to steal my phone, considering the fact that he came off as this really nice guy. I noticed he was still in the restroom, so I randomly scanned through Ben's phone. He didn't have any social media apps, which led me to believe he wasn't much of a social guy. I nosily decided to look through Ben's photos while occasionally looking up to see if he had come back from the restroom. What I saw in the photos made me want to throw up. It was photos of myself ranging from inside and outside the arcade. The photos range from a couple months ago till now. As I was swiping more and more and more, I realized that this guy had been secretly stalking and taking photos of me. One photo that really sent chills down my spine was a candid style photo of myself playing the Pac-Man machine with Ben standing right behind me. He must have had someone take the photo of us. I quickly delete all the photos of his phone. That's when someone named Greg texted Ben's phone saying, "Yo, Ben, is she still with you? I'm outside with the van." That's when I look up and see Ben staring at me with a creepy-ass smile. It was a smile that looked so exaggerated, I couldn't tell if he was faking it or being for real. I told him that I was just checking the time because I'd forgotten my cell phone at home. He then says, "Wanna come over to my place?" I honestly could have made a scene, but I took the high road and said, "Sure, but I need to use the restroom first." He then says, "Sure, let me walk you there." Ben walks me to the restroom, and I immediately took the opportunity to call my dad to come pick me up. I can see Ben glimpsing through the door every time someone exited the restroom like a creep. That's when I decided to tell two older girls I saw about my situation. They kindly escort me outside, only to find Ben no longer there. I then get a call from my dad telling me to come outside and that he has arrived. I quickly rush into his car and act like nothing ever happened. To this day, I'm still traumatized from the encounter I had with Ben that night. I lay on my bed from time to time, pondering what sick plan he was orchestrating that night. All I know is that I don't plan on going back to that arcade anytime soon.